Hello students, myself Aman Thakur, assistant professor at Modern Group of Colleges, Mingaria. Today in this video, we will discuss about the calibration of glassware. As we know that there are lots of glasswares in our labs, like there are pipettes, burettes, flasks, measuring cylinders of different sizes, there is glass rods, there are the china dishes, petri dishes, right? So what are these? These all are the glasswares that we use to perform a chemical reaction. So how to clean that, how to calibrate that, that we will discuss today in this video. So let's have a start. Here is the contents of this video. In this video, we will study about the calibration of burettes, pipettes, measuring cylinders and flasks. So before going to start the calibration procedure, let's discuss about the calibration. Calibration hota kya hai? Calibration is the important part when you are doing a chemical reaction. Theek hai? Or you can say that calibration is the important part when you are going to do measurements. Calibration is important where measurements are important. It enables users to have confidence in the results that they monitor. Right? So first of all, let's discuss about the burettes. What are burettes? Burettes is a graduated glass tube with the tap at one end. As you can see in the first figure, there is a tap at the end of the tube for delivering unknown volumes of a liquid. Why this tap is present in the burette? Because it is useful to delivering the unknown volume of a liquid, especially in titrations. It is a long glass tube with a stopcock at its lower end. It is also used to measure the volume of liquids. So, calibration of burette. How you can calibrate a burette? This is the step-by-step procedure to calibrate the burettes. So, the first step is, fill the burette with distilled water. Force any air bubble out of the tip. Make sure that the burette drains without leaving any drops on the walls. Number 2, adjust the meniscus to be slightly below 0.00 ml and touches the burette tip to the side of a beaker to remove the suspended drop. Number 3, allow the burette to stand for 5 minutes while you weigh a beaker covered with paraffin. If the level of the liquid in the burette has changed, tighten the stopcock and repeat the procedure. Number 4, drain water into the weighed beaker and cap it to prevent any evaporation. After that, allow 30 seconds for the film to liquid on the burette walls to descend before you read the burette. After that, estimate burette readings to the nearest 0.01 ml. Weigh the beaker again to determine the mass of water delivered. Now drain the burette from 10 to about 20 ml and record both the volumes and the mass of water delivered. After that, repeat for 30, 40 and 50 ml of water. Then repeat the entire procedure 2 or more times. This is the calibration procedure of burettes. By following this procedure, you can calibrate your burette. Then pipettes. What are pipettes? As you seen in the figure, it's a laboratory tool commonly used in labs of chemistry and medicines to transport the measured volume of liquid. The calibration procedure for the pipette is clean the beaker and the pipette and dry the beaker. After that, obtain distilled water in the aluminum flask and let it stand on the bench for about 15 minutes before determining its temperature. After doing that, weigh the wicker on a balance which allows you to determine the mass to the nearest tenth of the milligrams, and that is 0.001 grams. Fill the discharge pipette as recommended into the wicker and determine the mass of water discharged by taking the difference. Repeat step 4 until you have the results of 4 such trials. Then flasks. What are flasks and why it is used? Flask is a vessel used for making solutions or for collecting or volumetrically measuring chemicals. It is also used for mixing, cooling, heating, boiling and dissolving the mixtures. How you can calibrate the flask? Calibrate a 10 ml volumetric flask by weighing it empty and filled to the mark with distilled water. After that, fill the flask and empty it 3 times to perform 3 replicate measurements for the flask. It is not necessary to oven dry the flask between these measurements. Then measuring cylinders. Measuring cylinders are used to measure the volume of a liquid. For example, if you want to take 5 ml or 6 ml of the solution, you can measure it by taking the measuring cylinders. How you can calibrate the measuring cylinder? Put moderate amount of water in a graduated cylinder and measure the volume. Then place the object in the cylinder with water. Measure the volume of the water in the graduated cylinder with the object submerged in it. After that, subtract the volume of just the water from the volume of the water with the object submerged. This value tells you the volume of object. Thank you. This is all about the calibration of glassware that is in our lab. Have a good day.